I'll talk about anything you folks want to talk about. Don't panic. I've got more material. Don't panic. Huh? Otherwise, you should go, oh, great. We've got to write the jokes now. I said, what did that bear do? He went to the wizard. I'm sorry, what? Oh, grocery shopping. Grocery shopping is, boy, good. You know, that's one of those things, like, as a guy, you should pay more attention and learn things from your mom. That's, like, really helpful, you know. I mean, I didn't pay attention. I got a lot of rides in that shopping cart. I should have paid attention, you know. You know, I'm 4 years old taking a free ride in a car. I could have just, like, learned a little bit, you know. The only thing I ever paid attention to was, like, which cereal had the prizes in. That's the only thing I ever cared about, you know. Then as soon as we get home, I'd rip over the thing and, like, dump the whole bowl of cereal in a big, you know, just a big bowl. I just dump it all in there. Of course, my dad can when we pissed off. He just push my head down the cereal. Find that prize, boy. I'm gonna eat the whole bowl. But really, I mean, it's like certain things, I don't know, I'm amazed. I mean, I'm much better at shopping now, but when I first used to shop for myself, I go into a supermarket, I'd be amazed at some women who seem to have mystical, magical powers in there. Like the produce section. Some of them could pick up a vegetable, squeeze it once, and decide whether they want it or not. I'll take this one, not that one. Take this one, not that one. I didn't know what to do, so I just took the vegetables out of their cart and put them in mine. In the meat section, if I wasn't buying hot dogs or hamburger, I had no idea what was going on there. How can I tell whether it's marbled or lean or red? I had no idea. And is there a butcher out there to help you? No. Butcher's in back of that two-way mirror laughing their rump roast off of you. He's got a hunk of fat. Quick, cut some more. Get it out there before he leaves. You know? And I'm going, Ooh, white meat. How cool. Okay. One of the important things you have to learn what to buy as you're going to the store. You know, when to buy. Like, I used to go in the store and go, well, I know I want ice cream. I'll get that first. Yeah. Put the ice cream in there. Of course it melts. Thank you very much. It melts. Yes, of course. You're walking around, all of a sudden you're trailing chocolate ice cream behind you. What are you going to do with a half-melted carton of ice cream? Put it up on a shelf with the peas where it belongs. You don't have time to backtrack and find the frozen foods again. The checkout line, that's the white water of the grocery place, boy. Never, ever use express lane, you know that. First of all, they got the slowest trainee clerk in express lane. Yeah. Really, yep. Price check! There's 100 people with one item each. I'm shoplifting my way out of here. I gotta risk it. You gotta have killer instincts if you wanna get out of the supermarket. Cause sometimes, you know, I'd see like a new aisle open up. You know, you see you think, whoa, it's my golden time. You know, you see somebody just open up a new lane. You think you're cruising for it. You go, yeah, I'll be the first one in there, you know, right there. I make eye contact with a clerk. Clerk is flagging me in. Come on. All of a sudden, like some woman pushing a 40-ton cart. She's pushing 40 tons at 50 miles an hour. Just zips her cart right in front of me, you know. Should have learned something from your mother, sonny, you know. Then that doesn't mind, that, you know, that's competition. I don't mind that I get beat fair and square. But the one who pissed me off, that person who leaves the cart and then goes shop some more. That's rude, you know. Anybody does that to you, have some fun. While they're away, look at their cart, try to decide what other things they might have forgotten. I don't see any razor blades in there. Take some razor blades home with you. You look like the kind of person who enjoys reading some of these fine magazines they've got waiting. Then move to another lane, because that one's going to be held up for a while. Stop the register. I don't want to buy that. Enjoy your talk with a manager. And some of these clerks are so fast. Some of these clerks are so fast, especially these new coded machines. I don't know how anybody can keep up with them. They're just beep, 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 beep. And some people can still price check. They go, hold it. That's 59, not 69.
Whoa. Brainiac. Yeah.
Hey, I want to look cool myself, so every once in a while I'll go, hold it.
All right, go ahead.
I'm checking you. I'm watching you. I like how some people handle their change, you know what I mean? Because they get the change like pennies, you know? Like, there's one guy got his bag, and he just, like, started walking out. And the clerk was being nice. She holds up his change. He had pennies. He goes, sir, you forgot your penny. And the guy, he's real cool. He goes, let it ride. Let it ride. He thought he's in Vegas with $100 million in the tail. Yeah. Was that a penny? Let it ride. I'm all right without a penny. These pennies are worthless, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? You end up just throwing them on the floor. What am I going to do with these pennies? It's like when somebody gives you a 50-cent piece. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You ever get like that in the store? They try to pawn you off. They got that one 50-cent piece. You know, they're waiting all day long. They go, here's a change. They give you like 80 cents, and the part is 50 cents. You go, hey, take it back. What am I going to do with a 50-cent piece, huh? There's not a machine that takes. Give me the 2 quarters. Okay, sir, we were trying. We thought you looked kind of dazed in the eyes. You might take it, now I think about it.